time?
Because last time I cycled next year.
Yeah. What we're not doing is falling over the handlebars.
Yeah, I just heard there's a pair of tennis shoes in the
doctor. Yeah, yeah, no. Fair enough. That's a good plan, actually. That's a good plan. It's not skill, it's like, no, I'm not coming off. Not at home coming off. That's why I've only ever fallen off a horse once. It's just frightened. It's frightened hitting the ground.
I'm falling off a horse, you don't have much time.
It's a great motivator. And the fuck is trying to get you off. You not coming off. Limpet mode.
It's very rare though the horse is trying to get you off.
I know. Oh, there was one, he was renowned for it. Bloody arsehole.
But then, you don't know the rider you still had his back done. You know the tack they wear?
Yeah.
Has to be kept in that every 6 months. Because it doesn't fit. It's like your shoes fitting you one day.
Yeah.
And
it's
in the next.
I just think he was, what was his name? Keeper or something like that. He was fed up with being a school pony and he was just a shit. And he'd go out of your way to do things. He bolted with me on him on the common when they were out on a hack.
And
he was up to something. He was deliberately going under low branches trying to get me off.
Horses don't flip like that though.
This one did. I tell you, it was possessed.
A horse doesn't really realise. It just sits above it and thinks.
Alright.
They've got no view of above them.
Got the distinct impression he was trying to get rid of this irritating thing on his back.
But horses aren't.
Well, it worked. I bailed. Nah. It's probably exactly that. It's just to say he had a reputation, but it's probably. I don't know, I think, part of me thinks that they're like any other intelligent animal, like a dog, you know, they just get the mischief in them sometimes, just decide they want to be naughty. That's it. Someone's been round there on a motorbike at speed.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
I'm not arguing with you, because you know what you're talking about, I'm just a lay person that's just sat on one.
Sometimes
the ambience
and shit, they feel like horses, they want you to actually be okay.
See the riding position in this is much more funny, we had our terriers, we had Sophie the Yorkie, and Nessie the Cairn. Sophie would trot along pretty, ding ding ding, like spring loaded, and Nessie was just a little, we used to call her Nessie no knees, because it looked like she wasn't bending a leg. Bottom.
No,
well, trust me, we need to look at getting your saddle higher. Because you've got your, I'm just noticing your saddle's actually lower than the top of your handlebar stem, and it wants to be at least level with it.
Yeah,
it's pretty low. Yeah, it'll feel wrong, and you're straining your knees. I'm getting that bloody pins and needles in my hand again. It's so weird. Pardon? I think it's, yeah, it's certainly one, it's not easy. It's quite challenging. And, you know, you've got a fierce climb up at the start there, which really gets the blood pumping. Got a lot of, you know, regular ascents like this, where, you know, if you were racing, you'd think, oh no, this is hurting now. And you need to use your gears to get a comfy pace. And then the descent at the other side of it, when we're coming back round, that's very technical. You'd have to have a downhill racer in lobotomy to be able to do that at speed. Nice. I mean, it's a long, long, long climb to the top by the money there, but they wind down through the woods. It's lots of, it's a nice single track, so it's not. I think they're well maintained. It's a bit like skiing, you know, they've got the piste, I think.
Jake! Got
it! Yeah, look where you're going as well, Sam, because I will run you over. You know, disc brakes, because these are aftermarket Foxes, RFTs. They've got the bosses on here for disc brakes as well. But sadly, the frame's too old. I'll have to see if there's some clamp-on brackets we can get for disc brake mounting to upgrade it. But I might put the V-brake off the other one on it, because they're a little bit better than the cap, and they're a bit more powerful. I'll probably change the wheels over as well. Not look, the speed's on it. How peaceful it gets when you get into the woodland. You notice how much the sort of it's all suddenly muffled when you get into in amongst the trees.
Yeah.
The wind away.
I haven't done a dog count either.
Have you not?
No, oh. Off.
One. How many did you bring? Oh yeah, the brakes on this are shit. Georgie, coming up behind you. There's Domino. That's 2 chihuahuas, full house.